Wait, what did you just say? Like, they just dropped you off and they got you high?
They're doing tests, special training.
Can I do it?
As long as you're 18 and over.
I can go over there with them right now?
Yeah, go.
Well, help me, like, leave me
alone. Go.
City of Mora, Kennebec County. Where is that? Is that?
I've never heard of that.
And then the cop just leaves right with him.
They come into downtown Nicola and they basically pick up other people. Pick up random people on the street and ask them about the drug evaluations.
So they're getting, the sheriff's getting people to do drugs and then dropping them off back here at Peavey Plaza.
Yeah.
And what county is that? Says Kennebec.
Yeah, they give you free shit. They write you on the damn.
And they send you back to
occupy. No,
they let you smoke.
They let you smoke and they send you back to occupy.
They let you smoke the shit and then you smoke it right in front of them. They won't
say shit.
And they'll be like,
Thank you.
They, when we went up there, it's like 25. It's like basically all the police officers in a building out in Richfield, basically saying, basically it's a, by the airport, it's a training process. They pick up people who's already under the influence of weed, everything else that people smoke nowadays. But if you're already under the influence, they will pick you up and take you out there to give you some more of it to see how well your abilities work, to see if you can stand. To make it easier for them.
They give you food or they'll do cigarettes or, you know,
they'll give you the drugs for free?
Can I interview you about this if I burn your face?
Are you talking about the two cops?
Not necessarily, but yes.
They give it to you just to
you. You do it in front of them and that's it.
And that's it.
Like, you already have to have it?
No, they give it to you, but you use it in front of them and that's it.
Like, what kind of drugs? Like, weed? What else?
Weed, anything, but right now they're not trying to do too many stoners because they have quite a few of them.
So they have weed.
They're looking for harder drugs.
Meth and crack and heroin.
But what other harder drugs do you think they're...
From crack to cocaine to heroin to meth.
When they get you, do they ask what drugs your drug is?
They talk to you before they even make a decision.
Okay. Here on the street?
Anywhere on the streets. I mean, they're not just doing this spot. They're doing a lot of other places too.
And you have to be currently under the influence.
Yep.
And then they take you and they might just test you or they might actually let you use more. Is what you're saying?
Yep.
Picking people up right now, like they just pulled up here.
Really?
Yeah.
Good, how are you?
Good. We need a couple people for us. What we're doing is evals. Can you shut that off?
Do I have to?
No. That'd be nice.
Okay.
What we're doing is evals. We are very telephone. We do is people that are willing to come after they've done something.
In this category, we're just doing evals. We don't want people's names. We don't want to get anybody in trouble. We're here just to do some evals. So, like I said, if you can smoke weed or something like that, we don't care. We really don't. But what we want to do is just take you for about 45 minutes of testing, but we got to go down to the airport. So it takes, you know, 10-minute drive down there, 15 minutes. We do run 45 minutes of testing. We bring you right back, drop you right back off. So that's what we're doing. And like I said, I'm not even from here. I'm from Fillmore County, so I'm way south of Rochester.
They came up to me and asked, like, one from Wisconsin and one north from Maple Grove. And that should be right there. That was kind of sketchy for me. I'm like, okay, why are you cops from over there coming here? They're like, we're doing a drug evaluation to see what the side effects of, like, the drug you're using. We'll buy you a couple packs of smokes or whatever after you're done. They asked me what my drug of choice was. I said weed. And then they're like, okay, what? Well, people, one of them told me I'm looking for something more harder, someone to do meth or coke or something like that. I've never told a cop this before, but I said, fuck you. I don't touch the allocated weed and that's it.
No cameras.
D, I'm telling you.
You can't do that.
This is assault, dude. Like, back up. Like.
State troopers from Dakota County. Alright, I'll turn it off. But look, like, what are they doing? Like, can you just tell me, like, what are they doing? Like, okay.
Stealing my soul.
Sure. Let me just,
some other stuff, so
sorry
if you could turn that off and not even face it towards us, I'd really appreciate it.
Okay.
Like I said, my family's been threatened and me, my life, so I really don't want to be on anything. Okay?
Sure. I apologize.
That's the only reason I want it off.
Otherwise, I'll make sure any video I have, your face is not on there.
Well, the thing is, like I said, I really don't care what you guys are doing up here. I'm not from up here.
Okay.
So more power to you. Okay. But we're up here for a class.
Okay.
And we don't need to get in trouble for anything. Understand?
Yep.
That's the thing, we're not having people doing it in front of us or anything like that.
See, that's what another cop that I did it with the other day, he asked me what I use, right?
And I told him. We're picking up people who've already used.
Well, here's what I'm just trying to bring some attention to, I guess, at this point. It's like, there are officers that are giving people marijuana to smoke.
Well, that's not true.
No, it is, because I did it. I'm not a liar. That's
okay,
true,
well,
because I sat in the back of the state trooper car and handed me an evidence bag, you know, with the red sticky and everything, handed me that through the top of the bars, and while he was driving, he had me roll him up.
Well, I'm telling you that personally,
okay.
I don't do that.
I'm sure you don't. Yeah.
Whether or not other officers were doing that type of stuff, I don't condone that. Okay. So that's my direct cell phone number on down there. So like I said, on Thursday we're gonna be here from like 3 p.m. to 11 p.m.
Okay.
So call me between that time on Thursday, and then I'll be able to pick you up, and I'll bring you over to where we're doing the evaluation, and I'll bring you back to wherever you need to go.
Okay.
Okay?
All right. Can I ask one question?
Sure.
Because I was in there. Why is it that there are no EMT or any kind of medical personnel? Because, you know, if you brought somebody in who was high on heroin, and they just did it, and they end up, you know...
We have officers that are EMTs that are there.
Okay. So, I mean, okay. I know officers are, you know, especially state troopers, sure, or sheriffs are, you know, EMT trained, but I guess I was just kind of wondering why there are no health personnel, you know, on site while, you know, because there's nobody overseeing the overseers, you know, the sheriffs and stuff.
Sure.
So what if, you know, they're looking at their pupils, but
if we determine that there is a medical issue, then we get the medical attention.
Medical personnel at any of the facilities where this is being done?
Everything that we do is completely validated.
Okay? It's being run by the State Patrol?
Yep.
Okay, who's the officer? Okay, Department of Public Safety. Who's the officer in charge?
Why do I have to tell you that? Who are
because
you?
You're spending our tax dollars.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Well, he's a citizen, right?
And Jacobson from the Olmsted
right,
County.
Right, I know. Yeah.
Sir, and Jacobson from the Olmsted County Sheriff's mm-hmm. Department.
I've talked with Adam before.
Yeah.
We need to know who's running this program and whether or not adequate medical or ethical safeguards have been put in. It's a state patrol, but you can't tell me the name of the officer running the program?
The coordinator for the state, his name is Rick Munoz. He's a sergeant with the state patrol.
Okay.
It's called the D.R.E. program.
D.R.E.?
You can look it up. Drug Recognition Evaluator.
Okay.
Yep, you can look it up on the internet. It's actually a national program.
Okay.
There we do. Yep.
And there actually are medical personnel available when this is going on?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. Where do those medical personnel work?
Where do they work?
Yeah, where are they with?
Well, we're stationed out of Richfield, so it'd be the nearest ambulance service.
Richfield?
Yep.
Okay.
So next to the airport.
Okay.
West side of the airport.
What's the facility where this is being done? At the airport?
Cars.
It's the Department of Transportation. Why? Okay. We just look for a garage. It's just a big garage is all it is.
Okay.
It's where we can just do the testing simple.
These officers, like over here, were just saying that they're not giving away drugs, but all of you have participated in this program?
Yeah.
They gave you drugs? Or
They all told me that they were giving people drugs and getting them high off.
Okay.
Select drug of choice.
High off his ass. I think
we talked to both of you yesterday, and you were saying that they gave you pot.
She was there too.
She came after we.
And you were not already intoxicated in any way when they picked you up? Okay.
They gave you a bowl
and some pot to smoke.
Yeah. It was packed.
It was already packed for you. Okay.
Look what I found.
Did you ever get the feeling like this might be laced with something, or that there's something more sinister going on?
What they told us when my friends went, they said basically it's just part of a training process, basically. That's all it is.
Okay.
It's basically like they make you a urine sample, basically, all the other shit.
Just like you were going to do it like a traffic
stop. Like if you were dealing
like
with the probation officer.
Yeah, like UAs and all that shit, basically. Yeah.
Thank you.
throw this away.
I just realized those two were not messed up at all.
Yeah, man, I'm so fucking high right now.
Yeah, so like, tell us a story. Like, so what happened? Like, you guys, like, the last thing we saw was you gave us a thumbs up.
They didn't give us a test. They didn't test us this time. They just smoked us up this time.
Where did they take you? What happened?
They took us to the same place in Richfield.
Whoa. Right by the airport?
Stop, man. Yeah, right near the airport, yep. And they were gonna do the test, but you know, like, because of you guys, we couldn't do the test because you, like, you guys were giving them trouble and shit. But they still smoked us up, though. And then they gave me a bowl, too, and we smoked on them forever.
Wow.
For, like, a whole hour.
Was it
straight? Was they it? Gave us a whole bag of weed, and then we smoked it all up.
Like, the entire fucking, like,
yeah.
Holy
I got
shit.
Half, he got half.
I don't want you.
Huh?
They definitely don't like you. They thought I was fucking you. Now I see why. Because I was a good hat. You have the green bread. And I don't fuck. They didn't let me in there because they thought I was you.
Really?
What'd they say?
Like, you were recording. It's like, no, that's the little fucker that was recording in there. I was like, no, it wasn't me. So they're asking on the way back, like, if I knew anything about you guys, like...
Say what?
Like, if I knew anything about you guys, like, what you're trying to do and shit.
Oh, they asked?
You seem a lot more incoherent than when I saw you before they, like, took you and took you somewhere. Is that right? Like, would that be a fair assumption?
No, Cameron.
No, I mean, I'm not even...
Yes. That would be a fair assumption.
He was, like, high on methadone or something when he went.
Yeah, before he came, yeah.
Yeah, but then they ended up giving you guys, like, a whole black box or something full of weed and pipes?
Weed pipes and lighters and grinders, you know, the weed breakdowners, and then glass bowls, yep, and all that shit. They gave me a big-ass bowl, that shit. Come on, yeah, you saw it too, right?
And then,
let us smoke, like, 10 bowls. Or 12.
Because it sees it off.
We smoked the whole bag full.
And so how long were you guys gone with the police doing that?
Like about 2 hours, man. 2 hours.
Dog sacks.
So you spent just 2 hours smoking weed in front of a whole bunch of police?
Probably about an hour. And then the other hour was time to get out there and back and, like, just time to talk to the police.
Yeah.
Yep.
Did you guys go to the same location?
We went to the same location, but we didn't take the test.
All right. Why wouldn't they let you take the test?
Because of these. Because of you.
Because of the guy here videotaping
with him. Yeah. Now we would have, like, I don't know, have a plan with him or something, just to get blackball the police or something, do something, you know.
So they wouldn't let you do the test, but they gave you a whole bunch of weed to smoke, and then they just dropped you back off here?
Yeah. Lucky.
You're high as fuck right now.
You know it, motherfucker.
Did they drop you off again?
They dropped us off over on LaSalle and 12th, right up there, just one block away, because they knew they were on to you guys, you know, and stuff, because they knew they were going to get blackballed you. By you guys, you know, and you know, so they were already on you guys. They didn't want to get caught seeing us get out of the car. Shit.
Wow. So they thought we were gonna be there getting footage of you guys getting out of the car all fucked up, and then.
Yeah.
Did they ask you any questions about, like, Occupy or anything, or any, like, specific person?
Yeah, they're like, what are you guys actually really doing down there and stuff, and what's going on? Like, you know, they want to know all about it and stuff. I'm not one of the main people in charge. Like.
Oh, did you tell them that? Did you tell them that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, I told them all that.
So do they know who the car?
No.
Like, what were the questions that they were asking about the video people that were there earlier
today? Like, if I was with them and, like if I was with you guys and stuff, and, like, oh, since those guys were with you, you can't do this because those guys, like, we don't like those, or they didn't like you guys or something. Like, you were all the media and shit, you know?
What did they think we were doing?
Trying to get them, you know, caught and stuff so that you can blackmail them or get them fired or something, you know, like, for corrupted cops.
We know that they're giving you drugs. Is that, like,
yeah,
is that about it?
Yeah, they don't want that. Yeah, they see, that's why.
Oh, they asked what? What'd you tell them?
So the journalists,
So, like, how long did they ask you questions about, like, who we were and, like, what we were doing?
Free.
an hour?
I don't know.
Yeah, I got stoned with a couple cops.
You got stoned with a couple cops?
I'm high as fuck.
You're high as fuck, and this all happened in front of the police officers.
Yeah.
So where did this originally happen?
Well, I was walking down Nickel. You smell like marijuana, so I started walking a little bit faster. And they asked me how much I had to smoke.
Come on, how are you?
They didn't answer anything. And then they asked me if I wanted to smoke more, and stopped me on my tracks. Like, yes.
And then what?
And then I smoked with the cop.
How did they go about asking you to come with them?
They were like, did you come with us for doing research on people who are under the influence of marijuana?
And this was Hennepin County?
This is
sheriffs or cops?
Sheriffs from a different county.
Sheriffs from a different county brought you to the first precinct of Minneapolis, Hennepin County. And you smoked weed inside of Hennepin County precinct. And so when they were bringing you there, did they handcuff you? Did they tell you anything? Did they give you any rights or anything? Did they take your name?
Well, no, they didn't take my name. They didn't ask for anything.
They didn't ask for anything?
No.
They just wanted to see. What did they say they wanted to get from you?
They wanted to get information.
What kind of information?
Like how people act under the influence of street drugs. In this case, marijuana.
So they knew that you had already smoked, and yet they provided more weed for you to smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Was it high grade weed?
Dude, this is some of the best shit I've had in a while. Like, now I know what happens to stuff they confiscate. They bought me dinner.
They bought you dinner? From where?
Like McDonald's.
McDonald's. They brought you to McDonald's and bought you it? Through the drive-thru or did you go in?
Drive-thru.
Where were you sitting in the car?
In the back.
In the back. Was there two officers or one?
Two.
What kind of meal did you get?
You remember what else? I got a double cheeseburger.
Double cheeseburger?
Dropped me off back on Nicollet Mall on 9th.
Back on Nicollet Mall on 9th Street?
Across from the Target.
What did they say when they were driving you back after you got your meal? Or you were just sitting there eating? And
I was just sitting there eating.
They weren't talking to you?
Not really.
Did they keep notes? Did they write notes on anything?
How fast I ate my meal.
Really? What else?
I reacted to having food in my hand. Stuff like that.
Interesting.
Just to see how people act with the munchies.
Did they offer you any extra drinks when you were smoking?
Water.
Water? Did they offer you money?
No.
Did they say, come back and do this again?
They invited me to.
They invited you to? How would you get a hold of them?
I said I'd run into it.
Interesting. Are you thinking about doing it again?
Maybe one day.
One day? And they were writing about, like, maybe what they were giving you?
Yeah.
The drugs they were giving you? Wow. Did they provide a lighter?
Nope.
You had your own lighter?
I don't like using other people's.
Did they offer you cigarettes or anything?
I wanted to, but I was afraid that I needed to.
They had them with them?
Yeah.
They said, here, you want a cigarette? What kind of pack was it?
It was a pack of Marlboro Blacks and a mic.
Really? And you didn't want one?
No.
Why not?
Because at that time I was feeling a little sketchy.
Test, like little test, you know, see like how we are when we're high. Like they checked our eyes, checked our ears, checked our lungs.
Did they have medical personnel doing these tests, or was it the police force themselves?
Police force themselves.
Okay.
Yep. And they checked our blood pressure, pulse, all that.
Was there a lot of police officers there?
Yeah, there were a lot. There were like 30, 40.
30 or 40 that were just observing these tests being done?
Well, the rest of them were like in the office. There was like 10 of them, 10 police officers doing the test.
Did they ever, like, have you sign any waivers about doing this?
None. And they just told me, like, what's your name and, like, how old, and then they give up a fake name, you know, a fake age, fake birth date, all that info, you know.
Okay. You weren't uncomfortable?
No.
Okay.
I mean, no, not really. They never asked to search me, so no. And they didn't search my bag either, so I was good.
Okay. Well,
if they would have asked to do that, I would have been a little uncomfortable.
Pretty much state trooper and a other officer from some other county. I had asked if I, you know, participate in street drug use, and I told him yes, that I do partake in heroin, I do partake in smoking And he said, well, I don't have any, you know, itch, but I get, if you have the opportunity to smoke some marijuana, would you? I said, okay, yeah, fine. So they took me, you know, they picked me up in the car and handed me a bag of weed and said, go ahead and roll it nice and fat. Why don't you get nice and high is what they said. And after that, you know, they dropped me off at a river and I smoked two joints that they had given me. And got back in the car, went to a Minnesota Department of Transportation garage, did all these different sobriety field tests, like balance tests, eye tests, stuff like that. And then they bought me two packs of smokes, a sandwich, and let me go. Yeah, there wasn't any doctors, no EMTs, there wasn't even an ambulance on site.
It was just police force.
It was just police force and Minnesota DOT, you know, trucks, like the DID program looking kind of thing.
How many people?
They had people doing K2, you know, the spice, the illegal stuff, that synthetic. They had people drinking and smoking, just pretty much anything. They told me, I was supposed to go to the methadone clinic, they told me when I do my methadone to come there. Call them. They told me that one officer told me that he can't give me money to go get the drugs, but if I were to come up with the money in the end, he would pretty much reimburse me for it. So like $10 in the end, instead of smokes, he'd give me $10 cash, because it's out of their pocket that they're doing all this.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of weird. There was, you know, Big Lake, Ham Lake, Rochester, every kind of, all these cops there. So to me, it was just kind of.
Was it mostly sheriff departments?
No, like, it was state troopers. Sheriff uniforms are the same as state troopers.
And state troopers.
You know, they all got the light brown. So if you're not paying attention, you're going to see sheriff. But they were mostly state troopers and cops. There were some sheriffs that are overseeing, you know, watching the training, but it was state troopers also. I mean, yeah. They asked me what I did. They asked if I was under the influence of anything. I said no. I let him know, yeah, I do heroin. He said, well, we don't have, one officer said, well, I don't have any heroin, but if you do have it, you do it, or you need somewhere safe to do it, or whatever, give us a call, and we would like to do the evaluation. And the other officer said, well, hold on, and then we had re-proposed something. If you had any marijuana to smoke, would you do this? And I said, yeah. And that's where it went. He went into a squad car that was down the block, came up the block, pulled around, and I got in it. He had me a bag over the window. I rolled two fat joints.
So the officer gave you.
Yes.
Okay.
He gave me the marijuana. It's funny because he told me to hold it down underneath the window. So the public, I look like I'm hanging with my head.
He's acting like a drug dealer.
Pretty much. you know, it was funny because I was sitting, you know, with my head down and my arms down. So the public looks like I'm arrested, but in reality, I'm rolling two joints in the back of a cop car. Like, I was laughing.
Wow.
I'm not really teasing. And they just, all they did, all they did, they just took him to the back room. I mean, his heart rate was up. They know how to check it all, right? But they're not EMTs. So, you know, they checked his heart rate and everything. It was all up. His heart rate was really fast. Blood pressure was high. And he was freaking out, you know, bugging out. And they just took him in the back room for like 10 minutes and then let him chill out for a second. He came back. And then at some points, I hear them in the back room, you know, and they come back and they're like, nothing. And like, nothing yet. Now I don't know what that means, but he smoked a lot of that stuff. I mean, I looked at this one guy, and everybody in the whole joint at that point had been just smoking pot. So obviously, they didn't find anybody underneath the influence already, so they got them high. You know what I mean? They needed something. I don't know what's up with that, but you know, it's been going on for 3 weeks, so I'm probably going to be doing it for another 3 weeks.
Did you see any DEA?
Did you see anybody that looked like they weren't state?
They were like drug, like D.R.E. or some shit, like, you know, drug reinforcement or something like that.
Didn't it ever do any, like, chemical tests of your blood?
It's like a urine test.
They did.
They didn't even show me that. They have been picking people up, and if there's no room in the overflow in the jail, they will bring them to Peavey Plaza. They'll also give them a choice, especially drunks. They will say, do you want to go to jail or Peavey Plaza? I've heard that been said.
Said, would you like to partake in this research that we're doing? It's like, not really. But is there compensation for it? He said, yeah, we'll give you more marijuana, we'll buy you a pack of cigarettes and take you out to lunch. He said, we know who you are. We know that you're Panda and that you're deep into the Occupy movement. And I was like, dang, am I that infamous in the system? They would give me a quarter more of marijuana and if I said I would become a reformer.
Me being the devious bastard that I am, I said, sure. And I reneged as soon as I got out of the cop car on a nickel and a knife. They didn't really mention too much of what they wanted to know. They said that they would contact me when the time's right.
Did you ever have any like worries that like maybe the herb they were giving you or whatever you were smoking was maybe like in some way like
laced,
painted, laced, you know?
I never got the chance to pack it myself, so I never got a chance to inspect it.
Oh, so the police packed the bowl of weed for you
and yes. Handed it to you?
Yes.
And they packed you repeatedly?
Like four bowls back to back.
Really?
To back, to back.
And you never really saw what they had that they were getting this
right.
Drug that you were smoking from?
Right.
Okay.
I saw it come out of the glove box and into my bowl.
I see. So they had it in the glove box of their car. Huh.
So you were smoking in the police car?
Well, I was smoking out into the ramp. I had to get out of the car and then out of the car. And they were sheriffs from a different county, and they have no jurisdiction here.
Yeah.
What they'll do is they'll give you what you want. So if you want pot, they'll give you pot. If you want cigarettes, they'll give you cigarettes. They'll give you cash. They'll give you food. Just for taking part in the test.
Did they ask you what you wanted? Did they give you any of those things?
Basically, what happened was I smoke marijuana every single day, so I wasn't giving them the results that they wanted, so they had to stop the test early to bring us back.
Yeah, well, I mean, when did they first come up to you?
Oh, today, but they've been doing this for a couple days.
They've been doing it for a couple days?
Yeah.
How do you know that?
Because yesterday, actually, a friend of mine came up to me, and he was stoned off his ass, and he told me what happened, and I'm like, what? So I wanted to find out like, kind of what they were up to, and basically what they're doing is they're trying to observe the certain characteristics of certain drugs, so when they pull people over, they know what they're looking at. when you go there, there's like, when you first pull into the place, there's like...
Where?
It's in Richfield.
You went to MnDOT Garage? What is it? Do you know what it was called?
No.
It's garage?
It's out in Richfield.
It was a garage,
it's
a warehouse?
By the airport. What they do basically is, you have four cops that work with you. One is, one's the one administering the test, one's the one recording the notes, one's witnessing, and one's observing, like all the other cops. And they usually have like four or five, sometimes maybe six or seven people back there that they're doing tests on, so it's a shit ton of cops. It's very intimidating, but...
Is it all one big space, or is it
yeah,
bunch
it's
of
like,
rooms?
Yeah, it's like a really big indoor garage. Yep.
So when they came to you, what did they ask you? How did they come to you? Or did you go to them?
Well,
and where
they,
was it
they
at?
They walked over to us at Peavey Plaza.
Yeah, they walked over and asked us if...
Just asked us how we were doing and whatnot and got into the conversation of how they're doing a survey, asked if anyone wanted to participate in it. And then Dosa said, yeah, sure, why not? They asked them what drugs they were on, if they did drugs, if they did things like cocaine, heroin, things like that.
What kind of cops were they?
Some of them are state troopers and some of them are police officers from Dakota County.
Dakota County?
And many, many other counties.
Many other counties. Do you remember any other counties?
I don't. Shakopee was one.
Shakopee. Brought you out to Richfield. What time was this?
About 4 o'clock.
What day?
Today.
Today? What is it?
He's
April,
trying to break out
27th. April 27th? So they brought you back what time?
About 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock with a bunch of other people?
Just one other person that had gone with me.